Now, Saturday Night Opry would not be complete without a visit from Wee Willie Shagnessy of Dog Scratch, Arkansas. And I understand that he has had a very troublesome day. Willie, you want to tell us about it?
Woo, boy, it's good to be here tonight. I'll tell you that it's good to be anywhere. You know, I wasn't sure I was going to make it. The doctor scheduled me Friday for one of them colonoscopy things. Y'all ever had one of them? Oh, you ever drink that stuff? Man, that's terrible. You know what? And they told me to be down there real early, so I got out there real early. And of course, you know how it is when you go to the doc. Gotta get all your clothes off. So went up there and took all the clothes off, and they gave me that insurance gown you put on. That's what I call an insurance gown. Because you know you're covered, but you don't know how well. Just laying there in the hallway. Finally, they rolled me in the room, and you all know what them colonoscopy things are, and they rolled me in there, and I had a woman doctor. Woo! I said, ma'am, I said, I'll tell you what, I'm really embarrassed. She said, it ain't the highlight of my day. You know, a little bit, this first time I've been over on the main stage, and you all may have seen me around. I want to tell you a little bit about the family. I got an uncle, and his name's Filthy, but nasty. I call him Uncle Filthy, and as a rule, he don't drink. As a habit, he does, but you know, he rode his old horse into the tavern the other day, and that's funny because he ain't got no license. They rode him tied old Bossy up there to the tree. And while he is in there getting drunk, some kids out there turned the saddle around on him. And he didn't get home till about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and boy, my aunt was just worried about him. And finally he come in, and boy, he's really wore out, the clothes all ragged and everything. She said, my gosh, what on earth happened to you? He said, while I was in there drinking, somebody cut old Bossy's head off. And I had to ride home all the way with my thumb over a windpipe to keep him from choking on the dust. That ain't politically correct anymore. So I call her a refrigerator friendly, what she is. And she's always on one of them diets, you know. And you know, you guys know that if your wife's on the diet, you're on one too. Whatever she cooks, you gotta eat. She got on one of them fiber diets. Fiber for breakfast. Fiber at noon. Fiber at supper. Thanks, much fiber of the passive wicker furniture. Okay. And then she got on one of them she drinks Slim Fast. Any of y'all ever tried that? And she is chasing hers with Jack Daniels. She lost 4 pounds and her driver's license. She got on one of them deals. She was watching television and advertised one of them fly matches. You ever seen one of them? You notice they're made where they fold up and go on the bed. After you had one about a week, you're going to put it on. Anyway, she done that for about 2 weeks. Never lost a pound. I tell you what she could do, though. She she could crack a hickory nut with her knees. And then she got to reading the Reader's Digest one day, and it said, if you really, really want to lose weight, when you get really, really hungry for that fattening type food, strip off all your clothes and get in front of the mirror. So one day she was really, really hungry for that fattening type food, stripped off all her clothes, and boy, we didn't like what we seen. And the people in Cracker Barrel didn't like it either. Because if your lips stick to your teeth, you get you messed up here. She's got three pet snakes. She's got a mother snake, and then Petey, that's a little snake. And then she's got the neighbor snake, and they call her Miss Potts. So pay attention now. Petey, and there's a lot to know about snakes. You know, snakes, they don't bark or meow, they hiss when they talk. You'll probably know it. And they don't live in a dog house or a little house or whatever. They live in a pit. So Petey was hissing in his pit. And his mother come in and said, Petey, if you want to hiss, go outside the pit and hiss. Pay attention. So Petey went outside the pit and hissed, and he wasn't having no fun. So he come back inside the pit and hissed. And she said, Petey, I told you, if you want to hiss, go outside the pit and hiss. He said, it ain't no fun to hiss outside the pit. She said, well, if you must hiss in the pit, go over Miss Potts' pit and hiss. Better have a new one. So he went over to Miss Potts' pit and hiss. And while he was hissing in Miss Potts' pit, Miss Potts came home and said, Petey, why are you hissing in my pit? If you want to hiss in the pit, go join Pip Hiss. So he went back to his own Pip Hiss with his head kind of low. Not hard for a snake. And his mom said, why are you back home? I told you to go over Miss Potts' Pip Hiss. And he said, well, I was over there hissing in Miss Potts' Pip. And she told me to go back to my own Pip Hiss. Oh, his mom got mad. She said, that Miss Pop, I can remember her when she didn't have a pit to hiss in. Thank you very much.
Thank you. presentation has been brought to you courtesy of the Mike Johnson Video Archives. For more Mike Johnson productions, visit Mike Johnson's YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/BY1NO1 and Roughshod Records at www.roughshodrecords.webs.com. Y'all come back and see us, you hear?